I'm going to describe how to use an interactive simulation that is a model of a continuous stir tank bioreactor for cell growth. I'm showing here a snapshot of the simulation, and we're plotting concentrations. So here's the cell concentration for conditions that are selected here as a function of dilution rate. So the dilution rate is essentially the feed volumetric flow rate divided by the reactor volume. It also shows the substrate concentration, what the cell needs to grow. A couple things to note in this diagram. As the dilution rate, as we flow material in faster and faster, we reach a point where there's no consumption of substrate. The cell concentration drops to zero. This is called washout. And it's indicated here at what dilution rate we have washout. The other thing that we're plotting here using the y-axis is the dilution rate times the concentration of the cell leaving. It's also a concentration, of course, of cell in the reactor. And so this is essentially our production rate, flow rate times the concentration. And notice that it has a maximum somewhere, and we calculate that in the simulation. And then we can change the substrate feed concentration. We can change one of the constants in the kinetic expression for cell growth. And then this is essentially the other constant, the maximum growth rate. And then we can also change the cell death rate. So we'll look at the simulation, see how, as we change these various parameters, the maximum production rate and the washout rate change. So here we're looking at the interactive simulation, and the important thing to notice is that the scales on the y-axis, so on the left is the cell concentration and the substrate concentration. On the right is the concentration in the reactor, and therefore leaving the reactor, of cells times the dilution. And the dilution rate is the volumetric flow rate divided by the volume. What I'm looking at is how much product am I making per reactor volume. And if I increase the feed substrate concentration, notice that the scale on the left changes, increases, and the scale on the right increases. More feed substrate, then a faster production. If I increase the monad constant, this is in the denominator, and now notice the scale on the right is decreasing. And likewise, if I increase, or similarly, if I increase the maximum growth rate, essentially rate constants increasing, then of course the production rate, the dilution rate times the concentration increases. When the death rate constant increases, notice that now at zero dilution rate, no flow through reactor, everything dies. And now we have a maximum in the cell concentration as a function of dilution rate. But we have a different location, a different dilution rate that corresponds to the maximum in the rate that we're producing cells. In other words, number of cells coming out of the reactor per reactor volume. And the simulation indicates the point where if we have a high enough flow rate, we just wash everything out of the reactor. Hopefully by using a simulation, you get a little better understanding of the behavior of this type of CSTR bioreactor.